Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel, AA Lectures. I am Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and the topic of this short lecture is Direct Current Machines,
LAP and Wavefindings.
After completion of this short lecture, you may be able to understand some key concepts related with the armature winding. The coils in the armature winding are one of the most important components of the DC machine, wherein the electromechanical energy conversion process takes place. The figure on your screen illustrates the two conductors connected at the back, thus forming a single turn coil. However, before discussing lots of things about armature winding, let us first understand two basic terms, that is pole pitch and coil pitch. As we already know, the armature core has a number of slots on its outer periphery, so as to place the conductors of the armature coils. So, we will make use of number of armature slots for defining these basic terms. The first term is pole pitch. Actually, it is referred to as the distance per pole measured in the terms of number of armature slots. For example, if there are 20 coils in the armature of a 4-pole DC machine, then the total number of armature slots would be 20. Dividing this number with number of machine poles, we may calculate the pole pitch as 5 armature slots. The second term is coil pitch, which is nothing but the distance between two sides of a coil, measured in terms of number of armature slots. Also note that, depending on pole pitch and coil pitch, the coil may be categorized as full pitched or fractional pitched. This is the illustration of the full pitched and fractional pitched coils. If the pole pitch and coil pitch are equal, the coil is called full pitched. Otherwise, it is called a fractional pitched coil. Now, armature windings arrangement. Among several arrangements for making the end connections of the armature coils, generally, two basic winding arrangements are most widely employed in DC machines. The first one is lap winding and the second one is wave winding. This figure shows a simple lap winding where one can notice that the end of each coil is connected to the start of adjacent coil and the two ends of each coil are connected to the adjacent commutator segments. Moreover, in lap winding case, the coil ends are bent inwards. Also, you may observe that each successive coil overlaps the preceding coil. Hence, the name of this sort of winding is lap winding. On the other hand, in simple wave winding, one may notice that the end of one coil is connected to the beginning of other coil, but the two ends of each coil are connected to the commutator segment separated by a definite distance. Moreover, in wave winding case, the coil ends are bent outwards. And because of the wavy appearance of the coils, the name of this sort of winding is wave winding. Now the pitch definitions. Before we formally state several pitch definitions, it is necessary to mention here that whenever we say back of the armature, then that side of armature is referred which is away from the commutator segments. On the other hand, when we say front of the armature, then we refer that side of armature which is in front of the commutator segments. Let us now define the back pitch, front pitch and resultant pitch of the lap winding. The distance between the two sides of a coil connected at the back of the armature is termed as back pitch and it is measured in terms of the number of armature slots. The back pitch is generally denoted by YB. On the other hand, the distance between the second conductor of one coil and the first conductor of the next coil being connected to the common commutator segment is called front pitch and it is measured on the front of the armature in terms of the number of armature slots. The front pitch is generally denoted by YF In addition, the distance between the beginning of one coil and the beginning of the next connected coil is termed as resultant pitch, and it is also measured in terms of the number of armature slots. The resultant pitch is generally denoted by YR. Although we made use of number of armature slots for defining the back pitch, front pitch, and resultant pitch, however, these pitch definitions can also be stated in terms of armature conductors. Another important term is commutator pitch, which is defined in terms of the number of commutator segments. The commutator pitch is defined as the distance between the commutator segments to which the two ends of a coil are connected, and it is generally denoted by YC. In a similar fashion, we may now define the back pitch, front pitch, and resultant pitch of a wave winding. So, this is the distance between the two sides of a coil connected at the back of the armature called back pitch. This is the distance between the second conductor of one coil and the first conductor of the next coil being connected to the common commutator segment called front pitch. Moreover, this is the distance between the beginning of one coil and the beginning of the next connected coil called resultant pitch. And finally, this is the distance between the commutator segments to which the two ends of a coil are connected, known as commutator pitch. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.